Assalamu alaikum, rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace and blessings upon each and everyone who hears or sees this video. I want to start by saying La ilaha illallah wa sharuna Muhammad an abduhu wa rasulu. I bear witness there's no God other than Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his final servant, seal of all prophets. Let's talk about backbiting in Islam. Today I seen a post online by a Muslim sister that was apparently very angry about a so-called Muslim brother. I don't know if he's Muslim or if he's not. I don't know who this person is. But she claims that he's a Muslim and that he was saying things that he should not have been saying. As a matter of fact, she exposed this brother. She posted his photo, did a screenshot of their conversation. And apparently he was angry at her at some point because he said some things to her that he shouldn't have said. And in the process, she began to she was angry and she made this post online and was exposing this brother. Backbiting this brother, talking about this brother behind his back, and I'm not defending his actions by no means, but what I tried to do, what some other people tried to do in the post, is try to tell her to, you know, slow down, have sabr, have patience, don't answer one wrong with another wrong, and you have wrong upon wrong upon wrong, and it caused a big conversation. Here it is, the blessed month of Ramadan, where everyone is supposed to be practicing self-restraint, self-discipline, all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, said that the Muslim should be a mirror to his brother, meaning that we should correct one another when we see one another engaged in things we shouldn't be engaged in. That was my intention. Especially during the month of Ramadan, where the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, said every act of kindness is multiplied by 70 times. Some of the scholars say believe that it's 700 times. Some say 7,000 times. But regardless, every act of kindness is multiplied during the month of Ramadan. Praise be to Allah. And so my intention was to tell her, hey, slow down, because in the process she's using profanity and she's lumping all Muslim men into the same category, which is unjustified. You should not do that. Not all Muslim men, not the true believers, the mukmin. There's a difference between someone who calls himself a Muslim and he's drinking alcohol and he's partying at the club and he's talking to women the way he should not be, and a mukmin. Those who are of the mukminin, the believing men and the believing women, the true believers, the true believing men, the true believing women. Al muslimina al muslimati wal mukminina wal mukminachi. Surah Al-Azab, the ayah 33. Verse 35 talks about the believing men and the believing women. Not those who just simply call themselves Muslims, but their actions and deeds don't justify them being a Muslim. And I'm not trying to say who is a Muslim and who's not a Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our God, our creator. Only he knows that. He's the best of knowers. Says that he's closer to us than our own jugular vein. So he says in the Quran that he's conscious of all that we reveal and all that we conceal. But what we should do is conceal the wrongdoings in ourselves and in one another. Because one wrongdoing, if I expose my wrongdoings to someone, it may justify in their minds them doing wrongdoing, you know, them doing something wrong. And so we're not supposed to advertise and broadcast our wrongdoings. That doesn't make us hypocrites. That makes us wise, because we're Muslims, and it eliminates the opportunity for non-Muslims, hate mongers, anti-Muslim, anti-Islamic, Islamophobes to attack us. And we certainly shouldn't be attacking one another. We should be conscious of that. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, do not backbite Muslims and do not search for their faults. For if anyone searches for their faults, Allah will search for his fault. And if Allah searches for the fault of anyone, he humiliates him even if he hides in his house. So Allah is mindful of all that we reveal and all that we conceal. And so if you try to expose someone else in your backbiting, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to expose you as well. Notice I'm not mentioning who this sister is. I have no intention of doing that. But I am pointing the finger at the fact that she put this brother's picture online, on social media, and his comments. And let's just look at this realistically. If this brother was approaching this sister in a particular way, maybe he felt as though, by the way she carries herself, that it opened the door to him approaching her this way. Maybe it didn't. Maybe he's just approaching her this way, and he's got, you know, he needs to conduct himself in a far better manner. Either way, he's wrong, right? And at the same time, maybe she's wrong. Hijab is more than just a head covering. Matter of fact, I looked at the sister's photos, And she didn't have a hijab on in any of her photos. And matter of fact, one post was talking about she'd like to be on the beach with an ice cold beverage. And I'm not sure what kind of beverage she's talking about. It doesn't really matter. Because the fact remains that how we carry ourselves, the consistency of what we do defines who we are. So if you present yourself in a manner in which you seem provocative, or you carry yourself in a way that opens the door to someone thinking that you are approachable in regards to certain things, and I'm talking of a sexual nature between men and women, then you might want to rethink the way you carry yourself. Because if you carry yourself with hijab, not just the head covering, not just modesty in your apparel, what you're wearing, but modesty in how you carry yourself day in, day out, the speech you choose to use and not use, things you choose to talk about and things you stay away from, alhamdulillah, things you lay your eyes on, things you don't lay your eyes on. We all need to be conscious of this. And if we catch one another as our Muslim brothers and sisters, we need to be addressing this with one another respectfully. And I made every attempt, and I seen other people make the attempt to address her respectfully. And she and another sister in particular began to make the claim that we were attacking her instead of attacking the brother. Well, for one, I don't know who this brother is, and I was trying to help her by saying, you know what, be conscious about how you're presenting this information, because you're not doing him any good, nor are you doing yourself any good. And it also brought to my mind thinking, okay, what could be her other ulterior motive? Could she be seeking attention in regards to trying to present herself in a manner in which she is claiming that she's always contacted by multiple men? So she's trying to present herself in a manner in which she gets a lot of attention. Well, you're getting plenty of attention. There's no doubt about it, because you're using foul language and you're opening yourself up to hypocrisy, basically. And it's just the reality. And have we all been hypocritical at some point in our lives? Absolutely, because we're all fallible. None of us are perfect. We all make mistakes. But we should not be pointing the finger at one another and exposing one another. I stress the fact that I'm not telling anyone who this sister is. I'm using this as a teaching opportunity and a way to share Islam with one another, and to make us all mindful of the fact that we should not backbite one another. The Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, was to say again on the screen, do not backbite Muslims or anyone else. And do not search for their faults. For if anyone searches for their faults, Allah will search for his fault. And if Allah searches for their fault, the fault of anyone, he humiliates them, even if one is hiding in their house. Think about the things that you do within yourself that you don't want anyone else to know about. You try to cover it up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find a way to reveal that if you're trying to reveal the wrongdoings of someone else. So I love this meme right here. I'm not sure if Sheikh Ahmed Didat, may Allah be pleased with him, this is his quote or not, but it says, it does have, it has his name down at the bottom. It says, the biggest enemy of Islam is the ignorant Muslim, whose ignorance leads him to intolerance. Intolerance regarding someone saying something to you that they shouldn't have. Be patient. Have sabr. Be patient. Just because they said something, they did something that is displeasing to you, doesn't mean you should, it should open the door for you to attack them in various ways and use profanity and make posts and expose them and all these things. We need to be mindful of that. It goes on to say, whose actions destroy the true image of Islam. These actions are destroying the true image of Islam, especially when you categorize all Muslim men and lump them all into one big category, saying all these Muslim men are always contacting me, trying to get with me and all that. Remove yourself from social media if it bothers you this much. That's hijab, covering of one's self in modesty, in their physical self and in their spiritual and mental self. Okay? Cover yourself. And when the people look at him, they think Islam is what he is. So if you present this to society, that all these Muslim men are attacking or approaching you and trying to get with you sexually or trying to do this or trying to do that, whatever, then you're making Islam look bad, right? Islam is not what this brother did to you, right? It is not. Alhamdulillah, it is not. Praise be to Allah for that. Islam protects and uplifts the status of women. My contacting you, sister, if you wind up seeing this video, I don't know if you will or not, it's by the will of Allah, inshallah, you see it. I was trying to uplift your status and try to tell you to protect yourself, protect your modesty by not talking the way you were talking, not being so angry, especially during the month of Ramadan. Have some self-restraint. If you catch me slipping, do the same thing, inshallah. Okay? We should all be open to say, you know, having someone tell us, you know what, be mindful of what you're doing right now. Be conscious of what you're doing, all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one told you anything disrespectfully. Everyone was very polite with you and very, very kind to you and trying to help you, trying to steer you back to the straight path because you was obviously off of it. Okay? If you're using profanity, you're not on the straight path. If you're attacking someone and exposing their hypocrisy or their wrongdoings, you're not on the straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, period. We all need to be trying to navigate the straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of our ability. And if we can get someone to help us and give us a nudge back to the straight path, praise be to Allah for that. It says in the Quran, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, it says, and spy not, neither backbite one another. Would you like to eat the flesh of his dead brother? Would any of you like to eat the flesh of his dead brother? You would hate it. So hate backbiting. Alhamdulillah. Surah 49, Ayah 12. Once again, and spy not, neither backbite. Alhamdulillah. And spy not, neither backbite one another. Would one of you like to eat the flesh of his dead brother? You would hate it. So hate backbiting. We wouldn't want to eat the corpse of our own brother. So why expose one another? By doing so, you're eating the flesh of your brother. You're making him look bad. You're bringing him down. You're bringing Muslims down, especially if you try to categorize all Muslim men into the same category. I see Muslim sisters doing things they shouldn't be doing. I don't categorize them all and place them in the same category. We shouldn't do that, right? Alhamdulillah. So this is one of my favorite ayahs of the Quran. In al-Muslimina al-Muslimati wal-Mu'minina wal-Mu'minati wal-Qanitina wal-Qanitati wal-Sadiqina wal-Sabirati wal-Sabirin. Let's keep reading. It says in Surah Al-Azab, lo, men who surrender unto Allah, who surrender unto Allah, and women who surrender, and men who believe, and women who believe, and men who obey, and women who obey, and men who speak the truth, and women who speak the truth, and men who persevere in righteousness, and women who persevere, and men who are humble, and women who are humble, and men who give alms, give to charity, and women who give alms, and men who fast, and women who fast, and men who guard their modesty, and women who guard their modesty, and men who remember Allah much, and women who remember. Allah hath prepared for them forgiveness and a vast reward. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Notice in the surah and in many surahs of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his wisdom lists men first, telling men to lower their gaze and protect their private parts, right? Once again, for the men who surrender unto Allah and the women who surrender, the men who believe and the women who believe, in al-Muslimina al-Muslimati, wal-Mu'minina wal-Mu'minati, the Muslim men, the Muslim women, the believing men, the believing women, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is listing the men first because men are more prone to engage in things that they shouldn't in regards to laying their eyes on things they shouldn't. It's addressing men first. And in all of this, it is exposing certain things about men and women, right? And so the true believers are the ones that do all these things, protect their modesty and have patience and give in charity and protect their private parts. And praise be to Allah for the beauty of Islam. So I just wanted to address this. It does say that the best among you are those who learn the Quran and teach it. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts my efforts to share the beauty of Islam and to use this as a reminder to one another, including myself. Alhamdulillah, including myself. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts my efforts and forgives me for any mistakes that I may have made. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us all to the truth and protects us and has mercy on each and every one of us on the day of judgment. I ask you to subscribe, like, and share this video if it's helped you in any way whatsoever. By doing so, it may help someone else, and I receive the blessing as well as you. Inshallah. Praise be to Allah, our God, our Creator. I bear witness there's no God other than Allah, and I bear witness that the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, is his final servant, the seal of all prophets. Assalamu alaikum, rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.